That is the behavior of so many of us, though. We know, right? We present one face to the world, but inwardly, there is something internally happening within the heart. Hello friends, welcome to Look and Live. You are now here with Pastor James Devalon, and this is another reaction video I have for you. Creed on my channel today. This was recommended to me months ago, and I said I'm gonna save it on a playlist, and I'm making my way down. The playlist is long, over 150. I had to do another playlist because it was so long, but I'm knocking them down one after another as often as possible. So here we are, Creed, my own prison. I have not seen this. This is the first time I'm checking out this video. I don't know who this artist is. I haven't met him. I don't know who his mama is, who his papa is, but it doesn't necessarily matter because you guys recommended this artist, this group, or this band. That's good enough for me. And I take your command for it, and I take you at your words here. So hey, let's get into the heart of the message here. All right, friends, without further ado, let's get to it.
Quarters in session. Averted tears in.
Okay.
No appeal on the docket today, just my own sin. The walls cold and pale, the cage made of steel.
Wow.
Screams fill the room, Lord, I drop and kneel. So I held my head up high, I didn't hate that burns inside.
Let me pause right here. I love the feel so far, man. First of all, there is this notion of one's being in a position that he wants. He's placed himself by the decisions he's made. And as I'm reading the lyrics here, talking about cause insertion, a verdict is in. No appeal on the docket today, just my own sin. So this is talking about one's acknowledging the fact that he's done this to himself. He's somewhat owning up to his decisions here, the bad ones as well. So there goes the walls are cold and pale, the gauge made steel, scream fills the room. I alone dropped and kneel, silence on my sound, my breath, the only motion around, demons cluttering around my face, showing no emotion. Oh, man, this is definitely talking about a person being put in prison here and not knowing. But I'm thinking this is more mental than physical prison here. So yeah, so I held my head up high, hiding hates that burn inside, which only fuels their selfish pride. Oh, I said, all I held captive out from the sun, a sun that shines only some. We, the meek, are all in one. Powerful. All right, let's keep going here. This is good.
I feel the pain that was given on a sad day of loss.
Yeah.
A lion roars in the darkness, only he holds a key. A light to free me from my burden and grant me life eternally.
Yeah.
Ain't
That is the behavior of so many of us, though. We know, right? We present one face to the world, but inwardly, there is something internally happening within the heart. There's a brokenness. There is a wretchedness. There is a sense of guilt and shame. But sometimes we can hide our emotion pretty well, right? But he says, so I held my head up high, right? As if there's nothing going wrong with me, hiding hate that burns inside, which only fuels their selfish pride. We tend to do stuff like that. But I also love the fact he's also speaking about the other side of the truth, where inwardly there is this notion, I should be there on Sunday morning, right? I should be somewhat reaching out to God, but I'm behaving as if God doesn't exist. There is that inner desire to wanting to go to Christ for forgiveness, for a change, but there's also this internal struggle that is holding us back from reaching, right? So there's this reality that's happening internally, this battlefield of the mind, this great controversy that is raging in the hearts of the human, of the man. So he's kind of like picturing that here and in lyrics, and very powerful song, by the way. Powerful. Cry out to God, seeking only his decision. Keep us standing, confirm that creating my own reason. That is a good point. I cry out to God, only seeking his decision. Gabriel standing confirms, I've created my own prison, right? So there goes this desire to say, Lord, help me from this situation. So he's pulling out this confirmation from Gabriel. I'm guessing Angel Gabriel he's referring to here, is that it's showing that, hey, you did this to yourself. You created your own prison. But I'm going to save this, my last perspective, for the end. So it's very good to keep in mind, before God can save you, you must first acknowledge that you are in prison. You are a captive. You are a prisoner of your own doings. You've confined yourself. You've done this to yourself. I've done it to myself. And once I do acknowledge this reality, then crying out to God has more meaning, and it creates an opportunity for God to work miraculously in my life once I understand that I am the one who did this to myself. I've created my own prison. Then salvation becomes something of great value once you know that you are stuck in your own prison cells. Now, let's continue now. Powerful. Did you hear the outcry? I've created my own prison. I've done this to myself. Wow. Thank you. exceptionally amazing. Creed, you've done bless my heart. You have, in a degree, shared the gospel story without telling it. Let me say this. You just preached the gospel in a very covert and very intelligent way. I appreciate this. This was good. There are many things that I picked out from this video. One's acknowledgement of his decision and sins and condition. Secondly, is this somewhat internal desire to wanting to go to God for repentance and forgiveness. But there is also this exposition of the reality of that internal struggle. I want to go to God, but I'm fighting. All right. I want to go to God, but there is something holding me back. I have no time. I should have been dead on Sunday morning. I should cry out to God so I can understand his own decision. But at the same time, there is me standing in the way. What you're getting here is this internal struggle between the spiritual man and the carnal flesh, right? The carnal man and the spiritual. There is this contending between good and evil that is happening within one's self. So he's picturing that here in lyrical form. Powerful, well done, and I get the message. And one thing is certain, though, we have created our own prison. God did not do this. Okay, when you go to the Bible, look what it says, talking about Christ's mandate. Luke 4 speaks about that. Look what Jesus came to do. Jesus went to church that Sabbath morning. He opened the scroll, which we know today as the Bible. He found the passage in Isaiah. I believe it's Isaiah 61 or 62, or that speaks about this. And it says that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord have anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the, what is that? The captives. Did you get that? And recovering of sight to those that are blind, to preach liberty of them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable years of the Lord, right? But here is the point I wanted to focus on right now. One of the reasons that Jesus came, he came to set the captives free. And all throughout Christ's ministry, you notice him encountering with different people and setting them free. Mary Magdalene, the two men that were possessed with evil spirits, right? The men from, Golgotha? Maybe one of these cities, I'm not sure. I can't think of the name right now. But the point is, these men were bound with chain, but Jesus set them free. Different individuals, even some of his disciples, were freed from deception. Peter was freed from racism. So Jesus's ministry, Jesus's life and interaction with men, how when he was on earth, he was in the business of setting the captives free. And I want to say today, Jesus has not changed at all. He's still in the business of setting people free. And no matter how stuck you may be in your own prison cell that you might have created for yourself, my good news for you today from the Word of God is that God, Christ, is willing and is able to set you free. Cry out to him. He will set you free. Thank you so much for Creed. Creed, thank you for this one. Thank you also for sharing this with me. If you were, whoever you are watching this video, if you were one of the people who love these group right there, this band, let me know what you like about them and give me some info and educate me a little bit about them and what kind of content is this. Did I miss anything from the video? Was there more? Am I reaching and stuff like that? So let me know as well. And I would also like to know, whoever it is, share this with me. Whoever recommended this, make sure you point putting yourself out. I want to know who you are so I can publicly acknowledge you and say thank you for doing that. By the way, if you are new to the channel, don't forget to like and subscribe, join this channel and support us today, so on a monthly basis as well, so we can keep videos like that coming. If you're enjoying this type of content, if you're enjoying this type of message, also we have another channel dedicated for Bible study, so you can grow spiritually as well, called Look and Live Bible Studies. Make sure you like and subscribe. At the end of this video, I'm gonna put a link, so make sure you check it out. In the description below, we have many other links for ways for you to support us as well. I would gladly appreciate that. Till next time, remember, as always, to look unto Jesus and to live by faith. Have a good one. Bye.